the green flag waves at the back, and it's going to be lights on and lights out very shortly. And Moto2 is go here in Portugal. It's a really good start from that pole position by Philip Salat. He's going to get the drag down to the first corner, or is he? No, Canet comes through from second. He will get the whole shot. Salat's back in second. Pedro Acosta was really rapid off the line, but he's there in third.
Big mover off the line was Albert Arenas. Went right around the outside on the second of the IO bikes. He's up into fifth. He's trying to make that fourth now as he goes around the outside, but a shocking launch for Manu Gonzalez. He's dropped at least three places.
So Canet, our early leader in this season-opening Grand Prix, he has Salat for company behind him. It's as you were in terms of the front row starters, not necessarily in the right order. There is Vietti, but as you hear, for the top five, isn't it? As Lewis mentioned, Arenas was electric off the line. Fifth from way, way down the grid, wasn't he? Seventh, picked up a couple of places. Good start for the Spaniard.
Trying to see who he might have got tangled with. He came across the line in ninth position, just behind Arbolino and ahead of Binder, as Acosta now makes his way through on Philip Salat. So Salat, who led through turn one, he's now gone back to third again. And this is quite useful for Celestino Vietti, the fourth of the riders in this leading quartet. He'll be quite keen to put some distance between himself and the pack behind before he serves the first of those two long laps.
Jeremy Alcoba was super impressed with himself to get himself on that second row of the grid in sixth place in qualifying yesterday. It's as you were. He's held station at the start of this Grand Prix. Started at sixth, and he's currently in sixth position as it goes right now. And there goes Acosta. He's through on Canet. That was beautifully done. He came from a long, long way back. He just looked like he had so much more entry speed, so much more confidence and turning on that Kalex. And this spells danger, this spells trouble, because with clear air in front of him, Acosta's race pace throughout the test last weekend, throughout this weekend, has been, to put it mildly, scary. And now this could be game over in terms of the chasing pack, because Acosta, you know, now is going to start pushing, he's going to start to try and make a break early on. And Alonso,
Vietti
lifts up, picks up very aggressively Philip Salat. Nothing he could do about that Salat. He would have heard Vietti coming through. But that was brilliant. That was aggressive, wasn't it, by Celestino Vietti? Just trying to get as far up this pack as he possibly can before he comes in for those two long lap penalties. The contact there, or the aggression from Vietti, certainly helped Gonzalez, because he got through as well.
Yeah, he's going to have to come through there shortly. He's not got many opportunities to do that. He came from a long way back, as you can see. Salat was already turned well into the corner and had to sit up, and he'll be particularly cross shortly when he sees the rider who's just gone past him disappear out of view into the long lap lane.
It didn't matter what Salat was doing there. Vietti was coming through, wasn't it? It's like, I don't care, mate. I don't care if there's contact, but I am coming through. Jake Dixon has now just set the fastest lap of the Grand Prix. Regrouping after... Sorry, it's Baltus. Yeah, Baltus. Dixon has tried to regroup after a poor start there. He's in 11th place. Alonso Lopez, as we expected, has got a long lap penalty after that controversial collision with Bo Bench. So no wonder the tall Dutchman was very, very frustrated, because nothing he could do about that. It looked like Alonso Lopez was just a little bit out of control, just maybe missed his braking marker with a bit of slipstream into turn one. Lopez, though, irresponsible riding, and he will be sanctioned with a long lap penalty. Vietti then peels in for the first of what will be two long laps after his indiscretion in the season finale in Valencia last year. Pretty bumpy, isn't it, through that long lap penalty. Ortola nearly launched himself to the moon when he had to do it in the Moto3 scrap a few moments ago. Sergio Garcia and Sam Lowes on that previous lap picked off Joe Roberts there at the back end of the point scoring places. Lowes still 14th. Garcia run up in Moto3 last year, now 15th.
Arbolino was one of them, and here he comes through on the inside of Albert Arenas. Arbolino has got better pace than his grid position, and particularly his practice position indicated. The fourth man in the final six races of last season, he's now eyeing a chase on Gonzalez for that podium spot.
Yeah, behind Sam Lowes is Celestino Vietti, the man who started fourth, who has now served both of his long lap penalties. So he might be able to salvage a top 10 here, Vietti, as we look now at Manu Gonzalez, who pre-raced on the grid, talking to Simon Crafar, was very bullish about his prospects of fighting for the podium. That's exactly where he finds himself right now, at the end of lap 8 of 21 here in Portimao, the start of Moto2 in 2023. Although Arbolino's got through now on Gonzalez. Arbolino is a bit of a featherweight, isn't he? A pocket rocket. He'll be using some top speed down that start finish straight with the slipstream. So now Arbolino up into third place. The gap between him now and Acosta and Canet, though, is nearly 1.5. Acosta, well, you wouldn't put it back in against him, would you, making it 2 out of 2 at the start of this season?
Here comes Salac then, taking fifth place back again from Albert Arenas. He set that one up midway through turn 15 as he gives a little gesture to Arenas saying, follow me, we can both close in on this podium, Dice. Salac taking that wider line into turn 15 to fire that Grassini Kalex out of the final corner, get the slingshot down the start-finish straight, draw alongside Arenas and outbreak him into turn one. Beautifully done.
It looks like the connect count in terms of second place finishes in Moto2 is going to reach double figures unless late on here Acosta drops the ball, and that's not what we often see from this young man. We said, didn't we, midway through this Grand Prix, one of his fortes last year, despite his inexperience in Moto2, was time management. And that's coming to prominence again here. This has been a brilliant last couple of laps from Pedro Acosta, and it looks like he's going to deny Aaron Canet a first win in Moto2. He starts the last lap of this Grand Prix then here in Portugal with a pretty comfortable buffer of nearly 9/10 of a second. It looks like now Canet has given up the ghost. He's done everything he possibly can. Acosta just has not cracked. He has not made one single mistake as in this Grand Prix. Maybe a little twitch coming out of turn five at the start of it. Other than that, it has been an exhibition in how to lead a Grand Prix, how to survive pressure from behind you. Pedro Acosta, we expected him to be a big favourite to start the season from the top step of the podium, and that looks like exactly where the Spanish teenager is heading.
He's still lapping in the mid-142s. I think his slowest laps over the course of this last 9 or 10 has been a low 43. He's just given absolutely nothing to Aaron Canet, who did a very good job to keep Acosta in sight for so long, but in the end, he's unable to keep in sight. Arbolino has a comfortable third now over the Salac-Gonzalez battle. Salac looks like he's got the measure of Gonzalez, and Jake Dixon's late race charge looks like it's just going to fall short of catching that battle for fourth. Sixth, though, a good recovery for him, and seventh for Lowe's, also a very good recovery after their poor starts.
Well, when you've got MotoGP riders calling you the next genius, the pressure is on, but this young man's burgeoning reputation is just getting bigger and bigger and bigger. This has been an awesome way to start the 2023 World Championship Moto2 for Pedro Acosta. Not out of the top three all weekend, and he is going to end our opening Grand Prix on the top step of the podium. Pedro Acosta wins the Tiso Grand Prix of Portugal in Moto2 with a stunning performance. It's another 142 on the last lap. He finishes nearly 1.4 seconds clear of Aaron Canet, who gave his all. It's another second place, though, for the Spaniard. That's now 10 runner-up spots for Canet. A good way to start his season. Tony Arbolino does scrap his way through to an excellent third.
And once again, the FIM president, Jorge Viegas, congratulates Pedro Acosta. What a victory, what a superstar, as he starts the season, as he intends to go on. Acosta victorious at Portimão.